is the geometric representation of segments, and let us consider the essence of a geometric representation of a signal is to represent any set of m energy signals Si of t as a linear combination of n orthonormal bases where n is less than or equal to l. This is to say that the real valued energy signals are nothing but the S1 of t, S2 of t up to Sm of t. Each duration of t segments we can write Si of t is equal to summation j varies from 1 to n Si, Sij phi of j of t, where t varies between 0 to t and I varies between 1 to up to m. Here the coefficients of the expression are defined by that this is one coefficient and this is an ortho basis function, and this coefficient Sij is written by the integral of 0 to t integral base from 0 to t Si of t into, because 1 is Si of t into phi j of t into dt, where I varies between 1 to up to m and j varies between 1 to up to n here, and the real valued basis function phi 1 of t and phi 2 of t up to phi n of t from the orthonormal set, which is mean that the integral of 0 to t phi 1 of t into phi j of t into dt is given by, that is, the multiplication of two orthonormal is equals to 1 when, that is, delta I j k, that is equals to 1 when if I is equals to j, if not equal to j means nothing but the value will become 0 only. Here delta of I comma j is nothing but the Kronecker delta, and the first condition says that the each basis function is normalized to have a unit energy. Unit energy is nothing but the value is equals to 1, and the second condition says that the function phi 1 of t and phi 2 of t are orthogonal, is nothing but the 0 with respect to each over the interval between t varies from 0 to capital T, and here the prescribed I, the set of coefficients Si comma j, where j varies between 1 to n, may be viewed as an n dimensional signal vector is denoted by the Si, and the important point to be note here that the Si bears with the 1 to 1 relationship to the transmitted signal Si of t, and given n elements of an Si operating as an input, as we may scheme that shown in the figure is to generate the Si of t, which follows from the directly this equation, from the equation this equation is shown. This figure consists of a bank of the n multipliers, with each multiplier having its own basis function followed by the summer, and this is called as a synthesizer. That is, it consists of a, that is, summer here multiplied to Si of S I j into phi of j comma t. That means here j varies between 1 to n and here I varies between 1 to m. So consider this is an for the n input. So this for synthesizer block Si1, Si2, Si up to n, and next we are using an adder. This adder is multiplied with the phi 1 of t, phi 2 of t up to phi n of t, because this is a value of a jth term, that is Sij, no? So this jth term, and next is conversely the given signal Si of t is equals to phi 1 of t, phi I of t is equals to I varies between, I is having a value of 1 to up to m operating as an input, as we know in this figure. To calculate the coefficients of Si1 and Si2, here the coefficients Si1, to calculate these coefficients, which is followed by the directly this equation. From this equation, we are written in the, that is, the second scheme consists of a bank of an n product integrators or correlators with a common input. This is an common input, and with that fact, which is supplied to their own basis function. Here, the bank of n integrator, that is same whatever we are used with the basis function as a transmitter at the receiving side of, that is in the reconstruction also we are using the same basis function, that is phi 1 of t, phi 2 of t, up to phi n of t. This is the transmitted signal. This transmitted signal is received by the receiver, that is SI of t. This receiver is fed to the summer with an integrator, that is cost of an integrator, which integrates which of the symbol we are transmitting, that is SI 1, SI 2, up to SI to the power of n. And accordingly, we may state that the each signal is in the set of SI of t is completely determined by the signal vector. Here, SI can be given by the SI 1, SI 2, up to SI to the power SI. Here, I varies between 1, 2, comma n. Let us consider this is an geometric representation of a signals in case when n is equals to 2 and m is equals to 3. How we are writing, that is n is equals to 2 and m is equals to 3, is nothing but, let us consider this is an figure, that is yes, as we know that SI is equals to SI1 SI2 up to SIN, where here I varies between 1, 2 to m. Let us consider for a demo, for this representation we have when n is equals to 2 and m is equals to 3. For this n is equals to 2 and m is equals to 3 means here s of, consider this is for one s1 we are writing, that is s1 is equals to here I is 1, so 1 comma 1, then si, next up to n value, here the n value is 2, therefore s2, and s2 is written by the s21 and s22, and s3 is given by the s31 and s32, like this. These are represented in the vector, that is for the vector. This point represents the 1, 3 is the s1, and this 0 is 3, 1, this is s2, and this is the s3 point. And next is the squared length of the any signal vector SI is defined by the inner product or the dot product of the SI of t with itself is shown here, that is SI whole square is equals to SI of SI t in SI to the power of t, that is it's nothing but the transpose into SI, that is transpose matrix, where this can be written as a summation j varies from 1 to n SI square into j, where I is equals to 1 to up to m, where here the SI is the SIJ is the jth element of the SI. SIJ is the jth element of the SI, and the superposition T is represented as a matrix transposition, and where this is an interesting for a relationship between energy content of a signal and the vector is defined by an consider by the definition, as we know that the energy of a signal SI is T is denoted by 0 to T SI of T whole square into dt, where I varies from 1 to m. This is an energy of signal. Substituting this equation into above equation, that is as we know that in the SI of t is equals to summation j varies from 1 to n SIJ into phi j of t, that is this equation. As we know that SI of t is equals to this, that is substituting this SI of t, this value to the above equation, we may get that the energy EI is equals to integral varies between 0 to t. This SI can be written as a one term we are taking here, considering the two terms, that is for symbol 1 and symbol 0. For the symbol 1, j terms varies from 1 to n SIJ into phi j, this value, into here we are making a square, no? For that square, for the representation, we are using other symbol. That is, for instead of j, we are writing k. That is, k varies from 1 to n, sik into phi k of t into dk. That is, interchanging makes the order of the summation and the integration we may do, because both are linear operations. So, rearranging the terms, that is, write first summation as first first outside, that is j summation I is equals to j way is equals to I to n, and summation k way is from 1 to n sij, that is this term sij and sik in next integral of 0 to tb next phi ij into phi of phi k in t. Here, by the definition, as we know that the phi j of t forms an orthogonal is set to two conditions. Therefore, this value is goes to 1. Where therefore, the above equation can be reduced as an ei is equals to summation j varies from 1 to n sij whole square. Sij whole square. This is known as the sit into whole square. Therefore, in the case the pair of the si of t and si of t and sk of t represents the signal vectors si and sk respectively. Therefore, we know that the integration of 0 to t si of t into sk of t into dt is equals to si transpose t into sk. Therefore, the above equation states that the inner product of the energy signal si of t and sk of t over the interval 0 to t is equal to the inner product of the respective vectors representation si and sk. And next is the other useful relation involving the vector representation of the energy signal si of t and sk of t is described by the si minus sk whole square is equals to, as we j summation varies from j varies from 1 to n sij minus skj into whole square is equals to integral of 0 to t si of t minus sk of t whole square into dt, because the summation changes to integral and the square will summation value goes to and it means to sy1t, where here si minus sk is, this is nothing but the Euclidean distance of dik between the two points represented by the symbol represented by the signal vectors si and sk. To complete the geometric representation of energy signals, we need to have the representation of the angle delta k substituted between the two signal vectors si and the sk. By the definition of the cosine angle of a theta ik is equals to the inner product of the two vectors is divided by the product of their individual norms. That is, the cosine of the angle is equal to the inner product of two vectors is divided by the individual product norms. That is, sit transpose into sk is equals to si mod into sk. That is okay, the two vectors si and sk are thus orthogonal or perpendicular to each other if the inner product sit into sk is 0, in which case delta theta of ik is equals to 90. This condition is initially satisfied. Okay, next.